Mantra by our Divine Mother. Date 24th November. Our Divine Mother says, we feel the Divine is living in us, that we await events with serenity, knowing that His way is everywhere, since we carry it in our being. With blessings, says our Divine Mother. November 24, 1926. Siddhi Day, or the Day of Victory, or the Day of Realization. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo experiences the descent of Lord Krishna into His body. He explains the descent of Lord Krishna would mean the descent of the Overmind Godhead, preparing, though not itself actually bringing, the descent of the Supermind and Ananda. Words of our Lord Sri Aurobindo and our Divine Mother from the All India Magazine of the December edition of 2019, page 43, topic, opening of the centers under the psychic influence. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, when the peace is established, this higher or the divine force from above can descend and work in us. It descends usually first into the head and liberates the inner mind centers, then into the heart center and liberates fully the psychic and the emotional being, then into the navel and other vital centers and liberates the inner vital, then into the Mooladhara and below and liberates the inner physical being. It works at the same time for perfection as well as liberation. It takes up the whole nature part by part and deals with it, rejecting what has to be rejected, sublimating what has to be sublimated, creating what has to be created. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, it integrates, harmonizes, establishes a new rhythm in the nature. It can bring down too a higher and yet higher force and range of the higher nature, until if that be the aim of the sadhana, it becomes possible to bring down the supramental force and existence. All this is prepared, assisted farther by the work of the psychic being in the heart center. The more it is open, in front, active, the quicker, safer, easier the working of the force can be. The more love and bhakti and surrender grow in the heart, the more rapid and perfect becomes the evolution of the sadhana. For the descent and transformation imply at the same time an increasing contact and union with the divine. That is the fundamental rationale of the sadhana. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, it will be evident that the two most important things here are the opening of the heart center and the opening of the mind centers to all that is behind and above them. For the heart opens to the psychic being and the mind centers open to the higher consciousness, and the nexus between the psychic being and the higher consciousness is the principal means of the siddhi. The first opening is effected by a concentration in the heart, a call to the divine to manifest within us and through the psychic to take up and lead the whole nature. Aspiration, prayer, bhakti, love, surrender are the main support of this part of the sadhana, accompanied by a rejection of all that stands in the way of what we aspire for. The second opening is effected by a concentration of the consciousness in the head, afterwards above it, and an aspiration and call and a sustained will for the descent of the divine peace, power, light, knowledge, ananda into the being. The peace first, or the peace and the force together, says our Lord Sri Aurobindo. Next subtopic, psychicization. Psychicization, says our Divine Mother, psychicization means the change of the lower nature, bringing right vision into the mind, right impulse and feeling into the vital, right movement and habits into the physical, all turn towards the divine, all based on love, adoration, bhakti, finally the vision and sense of the mother everywhere in all as well as in the heart, her force working in the being, etc. Faith, consecration, surrender. Our Divine Mother says the spiritual change is the established descent of the peace, light, knowledge, power, bliss from above, the awareness of the self and the divine, and of a higher cosmic consciousness, and the change of the whole consciousness to that. Next subtopic, science of the psychic coming forward. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, a central love, bhakti, surrender, giving everything a sight within that sees always clearly what is spiritually right or wrong and automatically rejects the latter. A moment of the entire consecration and dedication of all in one to the Mother. That is one part of the psychic experience. The other is a complete self-giving, absence of demand, a prominence of the psychic being by which all that is false, wrong, egoistic, contrary to the divine truth, divine will, divine purity and light is shown. Falls away, cannot prevail in the nature. With all that, the increase of the psychic qualities, gratitude, obedience, unselfishness, fidelity to the true perception, true impulse, etc., that comes from the mother or leads to the mother. When this side grows, then the other, the presence, love, joy, beauty, can develop and be permanently there, says our Lord Sri Aurobindo. Next topic. The psychic being will materialize as a supramental being. Our Divine Mother says, I had an experience which I found interesting because it was the first time. It was yesterday or the day before. I forgot. I was there just in front of me kneeling and I saw her psychic being towering above by this much. And our Divine Mother gives a gesture about 8 inches taller. It is the first time her physical being was short and the psychic being was tall like this. And it was a sexless being, neither man nor woman. So I said to myself, it may be always that way, I don't know. But at that time, I noticed it very clearly and I said to myself, but the psychic being is the one that will materialize and become the supramental being. I saw it. It was like that. There were distinctive features but not very pronounced and it was clearly a being that was neither male nor female, that had features of both combined and it was taller than her. It exceeded her on either side, on every side by about this much and our Divine Mother gives a gesture extending beyond the physical being by about 8 inches. She was here. It was like this. Its color was, this color was, this color that if it became very material would be Auroville's color, orange. It was softer, as if behind a veil. It wasn't absolutely precise, but it was this color. And there was hair, but it was something else. And the psychic is precisely what lives on, doing away with death. But doing away, what's done away with is only what's not according to the truth. That's what goes away. All that's incapable of being transformed in the image of the psychic, of being part of the psychic. This was taken from a conversation with a disciple on July 1st, 1917. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says there is a dynamic joy as well as the self-existent joy in the soul itself. Next subtopic. Feeling the mother's presence always. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, you have been going more and more into the psychic consciousness deep within you. When one is in the psychic, one begins to feel the presence of the mother always with one. And this becomes more and more frequent, constant, vivid and real as the psychic develops its power. This presence is felt in different ways by different sadhaks, but it is a true experience of the sadhana. It is what we mean when we say that the sadhak must come to feel always the presence of the mother in his heart or within him. For in fact, she is there always. Only her presence is veiled by the ordinary movements of the mind, vital and physical. But when these become quiet and the psychic unveils itself, then one feels the presence of the divine within oneself, says our Lord Sri Aurobindo. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, love and devotion depend on the opening of the psychic, and for that the desires must go, the vital love offered by many to the mother instead of the psychic love brings more disturbance than anything else because it is coupled with desire. Our Lord Sri Aurobindo says, there is no method in this yoga except to concentrate, preferably in the heart, and call the presence and the power of the mother to take up the being, and by the working of her force, transform the consciousness. One can concentrate also in the head or between the eyebrows, but for many, this is too a difficult thing. These are the words of our Lord Sri Aurobindo and our Divine Mother.